यस, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। हाँ गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। गुड आफ्टरनून। ओके, सो टुडे I'll start module 2. Okay, today it's an unexpected class for me. Okay, so in this class I'll start module 2. Okay, in the next class we'll discuss the solutions to the assignment questions of module 1. The assignment questions I have already shared. Okay, I hope all of you have gone through the assignment questions. Okay, so we'll be discussing those assignment questions in the next session. In today's session, I'll jump to module 2. Okay, so module 2 starts with regular expressions. So module 2, it starts with regular expressions. Okay. So regular expression is a string that it can be formed according to the following rules. Okay, so regular expression is nothing but a string, but it has to be formed according to some rules. Okay, so first, phi is a regular expression, then epsilon is a regular expression, every element in sigma is a regular expression. So you need to remember all these. So you need to remember that phi means so a regular expression is a string that can be formed according to the rules. So phi is a regular expression. Then epsilon is a regular expression. Every element of sigma is a regular expression. Sigma is nothing but alphabet. So every symbol present in the alphabet is also a regular expression. Then given two regular expressions, alpha and beta. Alpha beta, that is their concatenation, is also a regular expression. Given two regular expressions alpha and beta, their union, alpha union beta, is also a regular expression. Given a regular expression alpha, alpha star, also called as clean star, alpha star is a regular expression. Okay, then So if sigma is equal to a comma b, the following strings are regular expressions. So phi, epsilon, a is a regular expression, b, then a union b is also a regular expression, a union b whole star is also a regular expression, then a b b a union epsilon is also a regular expression. So we have a language over the alphabet a comma b. Then you know that phi is a regular expression, epsilon is a regular expression, a is a regular expression, b is a regular expression. Then you know that a and b are regular expressions, their union is also a regular expression. That means a union b is a regular expression. So if alpha is a regular expression, alpha star is also a regular expression. So a union b is a regular expression, a union b whole star is also a regular expression. Then we have a b b a union epsilon, that is also a regular expression. Okay, okay, so language of regular expressions. So language of phi is equal to phi, the language that does not contain any strings. Language of epsilon is epsilon, the language that contains empty string. Language of phi is phi, language without any strings. Language of epsilon is epsilon, language with empty string. For any c belongs to sigma, language of c is equal to c, the language contains single character c. For any regular expressions alpha and beta, language of alpha beta is equal to language of alpha followed by language of beta. These are some of the rules. So alpha and beta are regular expressions. The language of alpha beta is nothing but language of alpha followed by language of beta. Then for any regular expressions alpha and beta, language of alpha union beta is equal to language of alpha union language of beta. Then for any regular expression alpha, language of alpha star is nothing but language of alpha whole star. Okay, then for any regular expression alpha, language of alpha plus is equal to language of alpha alpha star, which is equal to alpha followed by language of alpha whole star. Okay, so in the current, you know, discussions will not be using plus symbol. Plus symbol will not be used anywhere. That's why I'm not giving much importance to the plus symbol. Will not be using plus anywhere to write any of the regular expression. Okay, so for any regular expression alpha, language of alpha is equal to language of alpha. Okay, so then we'll consider finding regular expression for a given language. So here L is equal to W belongs to A comma B star, cardinality of W is given. So you know the language over the alphabet a comma b, then every string must be of even length. So can you give me the regular expression for this language? Every string must be of even length. Yes, can you give me the regular expression for the language over the alphabet a comma b, where every string is of even length? Can you give me the regular expression? Okay, so let's see. So here these are some of the example strings. So you can have any sequence of A's and B's. Only condition is that they must be of even length. So See, there are two regular expressions. So, you know that regular language is a language for which there exists a DFSM. Then, so regular expressions are written for regular languages only. So, here there are two possible regular expressions. So, given a language, you can write regular expression for the language in multiple ways. Okay, so here, as you can see, this is one possible way of writing the regular expression. So A union B followed by A union B whole star. That means every time, star means it's a kind of iteration. So star is representing zero or more. That means whatever is there inside can be repeated zero or more times. So inside what you have, A union B followed by A union B, which can be repeated zero or more times. But every time you must use both of them, A union B as well as this A union B. So if you're not at all going to use, then you get epsilon. Epsilon means empty string, which is of length zero, which is even. That's why epsilon belongs to the language. Then if you use it once, so here you can use either A or B. Similarly here, you can use either A or B. So whenever you use it, you'll get two symbols. If you use it once again, you'll get two more symbols. It can be anything. It can be either A as the first symbol or B as the first symbol. Similarly, second symbol can be either A or B. But every time you get two symbols. That's why length is always going to be even with this regular expression. A union B, whole star. Okay. Then this is another regular expression for the same language. So in this, you know that every time we will be generating two symbols. Here, with the two symbols, we can have four possible combinations. All those are mentioned. So here, if you use A, here also A, we get AA. If you use A and B, we get AB. BA, it is shown. Then BB, these are the four possibilities. So in every iteration, you'll be generating one of these, either AA or AB or BA or BB. And these can be generated zero or more times. That is indicated by star. Okay, so because string can be of any length, but its length must be even. That is the only condition. I hope this example is clear to you. Any doubts in this example? Yes, please let me know. Any doubts in this example? Any doubts in this example? Yes. Yes, any doubts? Yes, everyone, please respond. Any doubts in this example?
No, sir.
Okay, so this is one language. We'll consider next language. W belongs to A comma B whole star. W starting with string ABB. So can you give me the regular expression for this? Language is equal to W belongs to A comma B star. W starting with string ABB. Can you give me the regular expression for this? Try to give the regular expression for this. W starting with string ABB. That's at the beginning, ABB is fixed. ABB can be followed by anything. So can you think and give one regular expression for this? So it is, yes, ABB followed by A union B whole star. Okay, so you have ABB followed by either A or B zero or more times, because ABB also a part of the language. Okay, so if you want just ABB, you are going to ignore this, because star means it is optional, zero or more times. If you want ABB followed by something, then you can generate any sequence of A's and B's. Okay. So I hope this example you understood. String starts with ABB, that's it. Starting ABB has to be there. At the end, you can have anything, either A or B, or any sequence of A's and B's. Okay. Then W ending with string ABB. Yes. Give me the regular expression for this. W ending with string ABB. Yes. So it is again A union B whole star followed by ABB. Okay. Okay, so W ending with the string ABB. So here we have the examples. Then this is the regular expression. That is, at the beginning you can have any sequence of A's and B's, which is optional. Star means it is optional. It may be there, may not be there, but it must end with ABB. So string must end with ABB. Okay, so I hope this example is clear to you. Okay, next. So language, so one substring has to be there. Substring means it can be at the beginning, can be in the middle, or it can be at the end. Just 0 0 1. Okay, so the next example, over the alphabet 0, 1, W should have 0, 0, 1 as a substring. So can you give me the regular expression for this? 0, 0, 1 must be a substring. That's it. So all those strings with 0, 0, 1 as a substring belong to the language. So can you give me the regular expression for this language with 0, 0, 1 as a substring? Yes. Yes, try to give the regular expression for this language. Yes, so that is the regular expression. So at the beginning you can have any sequence of zeros and ones. Similarly, at the end, you can have any sequence of zeros and ones, which are both are optional. 0, 0, 1 is mandatory. 0, 1, 1. Right? 0, 0, 1. Sorry, it is 0, 0, 1. W must have 0, 0, 1 as a substring, so it must be 0, 0, 1 here. Okay, so this is the regular expression. So 0 or 1 star followed by 001, which is followed by 0 or 1 star. So this is the regular expression for the language for the alphabet 0, 1 with 001 as a substring. With 001 as a substring. So I hope all of you understood this example. Any doubts in this? Yes. Any doubts in this? Yes. Why others are not responding? Any doubts in this? Yes, others, please respond. Okay, next. Okay, these are a little bit complicated. We'll see it later. Now, let's consider this language. Let L is equal to W belongs to A comma B star. Number of A's, hash means number of A's in W is less than or equal to 3. Number of A's in W is less than or equal to 3. Either you can have 3 A's or 2 A's or 1 A or 0 A's. So maximum you can have 3 A's. Number of A's must be less than or equal to 3. So minimum 0 A's, maximum 3 A's. You can have 0 A's, 1 A, 2 A, or 3 A's, but you cannot have more than 3 A's. So can you give me the regular expression for this language? Can you give me the regular expression for this language? Yes. Yes, give me the regular expression for this language. Just try. Okay, it's not very easy. Not like the previous examples. This is a bit complicated compared to previous examples, but still it is easy. Okay. So number of A's in W must be equal to 3. See, there is no dollar sign here. You can use epsilon. You can perform union operation. You can use clean star. You can use concatenation operation. That's it. Other than that, you don't have anything. Okay. You can perform the concatenation of symbols. You can perform the union of symbols. Then you can perform clean star operation. That's it. So let's see this example. So these are some of the example strings which are a part of the language. So this is the regular expression. This is the regular expression for the language. See, B star means it's optional. Initially, you may have B's or you may not have B's. Then this is optional. You may have A or it can be epsilon. Epsilon means empty. Then again B star, A union epsilon. B star, A union epsilon, B star. So everywhere you see, A comes with epsilon. That is, it can be A or it can be epsilon. See, if in every place you get A, here also A, here also A, here also A, means you'll receive 3 A's. So only in 3 places you find A's. That is maximum you can have 3 A's. Minimum, if everywhere you use epsilon, here also epsilon, 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 then you get 0 A's. If you use A, epsilon, epsilon, you get 1 A. Then, if you use A, epsilon, you get 2 A. So you can generate 0 A's, 1 A, 2 A, or 3 A's. So all possibilities can be generated by this particular regular expression. Okay. So B star means string may begin with B. It's optional. Then you may have a A, which is again separated by some number of B's. You may have one more A, again separated by some number of B's. One more A, again separated by some number of B's. So this regular expression is going to cover all possibilities. So is this clear, or any doubts, any further explanation needed for this? Please let me know. Please let me know. Just consider this example once again. Okay, just try to analyze it once again. You'll understand. Not that difficult. If any doubts, please let me know. Yes. Yes, why others are not responding? Please, if please, I request everyone to respond. Okay, so that's the only way I come to know whether you have understood or not. Okay. Then language over the alphabet 0, 1, W contains at least 2 zeros, same as previous one. Here at least, no, here it is at most 3 zeros, at most. Here it is at least. See, there is a difference here. So here in the previous example it was maximum 3 zeros you can have, minimum can be 0 also, but here minimum is 2. So W must contain at least 2 zeros. At least 2 zeros must be there, but you can have more than 2 zeros also, but at least 2 are must. So can you give the regular expression for this language? W contains at least 2 zeros. Can you give me the regular expression for this? Just try to give the regular expression for this language. Language over the alphabet 0, 1. W contains at least 2 zeros. These are examples. Okay. These are the examples. Now I want the regular expressions. Okay, these are the examples. At least 2 zeros. So here, okay, in the first example you have 2 zeros, then you have 3 zeros, then you have 2 zeros. Okay, okay, all are valid examples, but can you give me the regular expression? Can you give me the regular expression for the language with at least 2 zeros? So these are the examples. Okay, so see here, this cannot be the regular expression at all, right? Because everywhere you have option. Star means it is optional, it is not at all mandatory. So star means you may use or you may not use. Here in both the places you have star. See, here in this particular subject we don't use comma. In place of comma always you use union operation. Don't put this comma. So in the previous also someone gave example with comma. So this comma we are not using. Wherever you want comma, the comma means it's either 1 or 0, which is represented by union operation. So here in both the places star, that means both are optional. That means you may not use both of them. That means you get epsilon. Epsilon means where you have at least 2 zeros. Where is that clause satisfied? So this cannot be the regular expression at all. Yes, others, please give some examples for the regular expression for the language with at least 2 zeros. Yes, all of you please try. Give me the regular expression. W contains at least 2 zeros. That is, 2 zeros are mandatory. You cannot have star over those 2 zeros. 2 zeros are must. If you don't have 2 zeros, then that cannot be the regular expression for this language. Yes, others, please try. Yes. Think for some time and give me the answer. So W contains at least 2 zeros. this? Is anybody? Okay. See, when you write regular expressions, you need to consider all possibilities. Okay, so this is okay. So this was given. Okay, so both are almost same. Both examples are almost same. Okay, this is the right regular expression. So here, this is the right regular expression. 1 or 0 star followed by 0 followed by 1 or 0 star followed by 0 followed by 1 or 0 star. Because at least 2 zeros are mandatory. They can be anywhere. They can be embedded in between ones in any manner. Okay, that's why you need to consider all possibilities. So this is the correct regular expression. Okay, so we have this. So here, see, zero zeros, these 2 zeros need not be together always. They may be separated by ones. At least 2 zeros are needed. That's it. There is no condition that those 2 zeros must be together, must be adjacent to each other. There is no such condition. They may be separated by ones, but that cannot happen with this regular expression. Okay, but good attempt. Okay, so here, see, this is the regular expression. So all strings can be generated with this. See, you can generate 0, 0 because every other parts are optional. You can eliminate this. What remains is 0, 0. How you'll generate 1, 0, 1, 0? You generate 1 from here, 0 or 1. You generate a single 1, then you generate, use this 0, then 1, then you 0, and this one you don't use at all. You just neglect it because star means it's optional. So 1, 0, 1, 0. Then 1, 1, 0, 0. How you generate 2 ones from here, 1, 1, then 0, just neglect this, then 0. Then 0, 0, 0, 1. How? So you can generate 0 from here, just neglect the first one, 0, neglect this, 0, 2 zeros you got. Then here, in the first iteration, you generate a 0, next iteration, you generate a 1, you get 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so this is the right regular expression, 0 or 1 star, 0, 0 or 1 star, 0, 0 or 1 star. Okay, then consider this, a power n, b power n, b power m, n greater than or equal to 4, m less than or equal to 3. Okay, so you can have a's, at least 4 a's must be there. So you know that language is a power n, b power m. That means initially only a's followed by only b's, like that. So at least 4 A's must be there at the beginning. N must be greater than or equal to 4. Then at the end, you can have a maximum of 3 A's, 3 B's. So at most, like at least 4 A's, at least 3 B's. So at most, sorry. So here at least 4 A's, then at most 3 B's. Okay. So here, number of A's must be greater than or equal to 4. Number of B's must be less than or equal to 3. So can you give me the regular expression for this? But now there is one thing, that is, at the beginning only A's, next you have only B's. So can you give me the regular expression for this? What is that M? Yes, Anvith, what is that M? M or union? E. What is the meaning of M union E? What is M? There is nothing. See, while writing the regular expression, you cannot use these symbols. M and N, they are just, they are not the symbols of the alphabet. Okay. Symbols of the alphabet are only A and B. So others, these are just, you know, just they represent how many A's are there, how many B's need to be there. So these M and N cannot appear in the regular expression. Okay, so yes, correct it and send. What is E here? What is E? Is it epsilon or what is it? E is representing what? So again, see, this cannot be the regular expression. As I told, in this language you have only s at the beginning. In the beginning, n number of s followed by m number of b's. But here it is not so. You have a, b, like a's appear then b's, then a's then b's. Not like that. Language is such that strings have only a's at the beginning. Beginning only a's, ending only b's, like that. So just try to give the answer for this. N must be greater than or equal to 4. M should be less than or equal to 3. Yes, think and answer. Yes, again, why you are doing the typing mistake? Correct it and give me. Why you are typing M? Yes, Anvit, correct it and send. Yes, others can also give the answer. Please think and answer. See, if it is wrong, no problem. Okay, if it is wrong, not a problem. See, I think here you are writing. So, I think you are representing E as epsilon, okay? But this is almost correct. Almost correct, but not completely correct. See, the last part is correct. That is, M should be less than or equal to 3. That means you can have maximum 3 bits. That part is correct. Because here, B or epsilon, B or epsilon, B or epsilon. If all are epsilon, you get 0 bits. If all are bits, you get maximum 3 bits. That is correct. But at the beginning, N must be greater than or equal to 4. Here, only 3 A's are mandatory. 4th is optional. That means you can have 3 A's also. You can have 3 A's also. That means this is the correct answer. 4 A's followed by A star. Then you have B union epsilon 3 times. Okay. So this is the regular expression. Okay. Or else you can write in this way also. Both are correct. Both are correct. Your answer is also correct. So 4 A's are must, because N must be greater than or equal to 4. 4 A's must be there. You can have more than 4 A's also. That's why A star. But 4 A's are mandatory, which are represented directly. Then A star means if you want more than 4, you use this. Then you can have a maximum of 3 B's. So epsilon you can have, or 1 B, or 2 B's, or 3 B's. Or you can write in this way also. This is also correct. Okay, this is also correct. Okay, so I hope all are following it. Okay, then we'll consider this one. L is equal to a power n, b power m. N less than or equal to 4, m greater than or equal to 2. Okay, can you give me the regular expression for this language? I think it's almost similar to the previous one. So you can have at most 4 years. N must be less than or equal to 4. At most 4 years. Then at least 2 bs. At least 2 bs. Okay. So in the same way, this why screen is not visible? Screen sharing is on. One second. Let me. Is it visible now? Okay, so this is the example. So just give the regular expression for this. Yes. So here we have some regular expressions. Let's see. So a power n, n less than or equal to 4. So either epsilon, okay, that is correct, or a, okay. So at most 4 a's are allowed, that is correct. At most 4 a's followed by at least 2 b's. So 2 b's are must followed by a b star. Okay, this one is correct. So what about this? This is not the regular expression for this problem. So this one is similar to the previous problem. Your solution is for the previous problem, not exactly, but similar to that. Now we have a different situation. Okay, so what else you can here? Yeah. So this one is the correct answer. So you have at most 4 a's. So epsilon or a followed by at least 2 b's. You can have more b's also, b star. So here what is happening? See, here what is this? You must have 4 b's, but that is not the condition. You may not have 4 b's all the time. You must have maximum of 4 b's, but less than 4, not b's, sorry, what is it? A's. Okay, so according to this, 4 a's are mandatory, but that's not so. Maximum 4 a's, you can have less number of a's also, but there is no way to match less number of a's. At least 4 must be there. That is not the correct one. So here, a union epsilon, yes, this can be another option. So here, you can generate only epsilon, 4 a's, 2 a's, 1 a, 3 a, everything can be generated, then at least 2 b's. Okay, so this is also correct. This regular expression is also correct. So then consider this one, a power 2n, b power 2m. A power 2n, b power 2m. Can you give me the regular expression for this? N greater than or equal to 0, m greater than or equal to 0. Just try to give the regular expression for this. The a power 2n, b power 2m. So when n is 0, n and m both are 0, you have a power 0, b power 0. That means epsilon must be a part of the language. When n equal to 1, m equal to 1, what do you get? A power 2, b power 2. That means 2 a's, 2 b's. When n is 2, you get a power 4, 4 a's. That means every time you must have even number of a's followed by even number of b's. That is the condition here. 2 a power 2n means, and b power 2m means, always you have even number of a's followed by even number of b's. Number of a's and b's need not be equal, but number of a's should be even as well as number of b's should be even. That's it. So you have a star b b star. That is the correct answer. So you have a, it will always generate even number of a's. BB will always generate even number of B's. So this is the regular expression for the language. Okay. Now, with this language, can you use the regular expression? A power N, B power M, M plus N is even. Can you give the regular expression for this? Can you give the regular expression for this? So m plus n is even, that is number of a's and b's should be such that, so you have n number of a's followed by m number of b's, but number of a's and b's are such that the total length is always e1. Okay, so this is a bit complicated. So for m plus n to be even, either m and n both should be even. That is, you consider 2 plus 2, how much? 4. Both are even, 2, 2. Then 4, 4, 8. Then which one? 2, 4. So n is 2, m is 4. 2 plus 4 is 6. So either m and n both must be even or m and n both must be odd. 3 plus 3, 6. 5 plus 3, 8. Then 3 plus 9, 12. So that is the condition. So their sum for m plus n to be even, either m and n both of them must be even or both of them must be odd. So you need to write regular expression by keeping this in mind. So a bit complicated this is. Let's see. Is it m plus n is even? Okay. Okay, this one, how to read this? A star B B star union A star union B star. Very, I'm not able to understand properly. So here A union B whole star. A union B B star. See, first place everything is wrong, because you need to have A's followed by B's. You cannot mix A's and B's. A's here, B's, then A's, then B's. That cannot happen. First only A's, then only B's. Regular expression should generate only those strings, because you have n number of A's followed by m number of B's. So first, in the regular expression, you should be able to generate only A's. N number of A's you generate, then you generate M number of B's. Okay, then you generate M number of B's. So now with this, can you give some examples? Can you give the regular expression? Can you give the regular expression? See, one part is already there. Already you have answered for this. A star, B star, what it will do? So every time, so m plus n is even, right? Either 2 A's, 2 B's, or 4 A's, 2 B's, or 6 A's, 2 B's, 4 A's, 6 B's, like that. You are generating even number of A's followed by even number of B's. Even plus even is always even. That is one possibility. Okay. So m plus n is even when both a's and b's are even or both are odd. So this is the regular expression. Okay, consider here n is even, m is also even. Here n is odd because one a is there. This a star means it will generate only even number of a's. Even plus one a means odd. Here b will generate always even number of a's plus one, odd. So here you have even number of A's followed by even number of B's. Even plus even is even. M plus N is even. Here, odd number of A's followed by odd number of A's. Odd plus odd is even. So either this or this. Okay. So is this clear now? Any doubts in this? Yes, any doubts in this regular expression? Yes, any doubts in this regular expression? Yes, any doubts? Anybody? If anybody is having any doubts, please let me know. If no doubts, then also please let me know. Yes. Make it fast. Any doubts? Yes, quickly respond. Any doubts? What that star means? So you have not understood till now what that star means. Without understanding this, why you kept quiet from that time? It means you cannot understand anything without this. Any questions should be asked at the right time always. Okay, no problem. But still always see star we are using from the first example. From long back we are using star. Now we are asking what is star? Okay. Okay, we consider one simple example for that. Consider this one. W starting with the string ABB. So string ABB followed by A or B. Union means or. A or B. Star means zero or more times. That's it. So ABB is followed by either A or B, zero or more times. Star means that's it. It can be zero or more number of repetitions. The string must start with ABB. So here consider some examples. ABB, first one. So how to match ABB using this regular expression? We want ABB only. ABB star means zero or more times you are going to repeat this. So I'm right now I'm going to repeat it zero times. What remains? ABB. This is matched ABB. Then ABB, ABB from here I'm going to generate A. That's it. I'll generate only A or B. I use it only once, I'll generate A. Then here A, B, B followed by B. A or B, I'll use it only once, I'll generate B. A, B, B followed by A, B. So A, B, B is fixed. In the first iteration, I'll generate A. Second time, I'll generate B. So I hope this is clear now. So star means whatever is under that can be generated zero or more times. Here, star is applicable to A or B. So A or B can be generated zero or more times. You can generate either A or B. So first time you may generate A, second time you may generate B, A, B, any sequence you can generate. So is it clear now? Yes, Nida, is it clear now? Why so much delay in asking such basic questions? So have you understood the examples what we discussed? Yes, Nida, did you understand the examples? Without this, how can you understand? That is not possible. Okay, answer attendance. Sushmita. 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 Adarsh.
Present, sir.
Present, sir. Present, sir.
Amal.
Present, sir.
Present,
Amen.
Sir.
Present, sir.
Archana.
Present, sir.
Archana.
Present, sir.
Ashika.
Present, sir.
Ashwath. Atufa.
Present, sir.
Atufa.
Aisha. Present, sir. Present, sir.
Bhakti.
Present, sir.
Bhakti. Chirag.
Present, sir.
Hari Prasad.
Present, sir.
Harshit. Harshit. Ibrahim. Ibrahim.
Present, sir.
Kaushik.
Present, sir.
Kaushik. Kaushik. Azi. Anisha.
Present, sir.
Anisha. Mohit.
Present, sir.
Mohit. Lavanya.
Present, sir. Present.
Lavanya. Faizan.
Present, sir.
Faizan. Ayik. Isham. Aulia.
Present, sir.
Nida. Pooja.
Present, sir.
Present, sir.
Present, sir. Pranav. Prasad.
Present, sir.
Prashanti.
Present, Shifa. Sir.
Pratiksha.
Present, sir.
Pratiksha.
Present, sir.
Shifa.
Present, sir.
Pratiksha. Pratiksha.
Present, sir.
Rifa.
Present, sir.
Rifa. Rifa, Rohan,
present sir.
Roshni,
present sir.
Who is that? Who is that? Roshni,
present sir.
Sahana, Sahana. Hi Niketan. Angir. Rafa.
Present sir.
Karanya.
Present sir.
Chitra.
Present sir.
Shrestha.
Present sir.
Viraksha.
Present sir.
Shweta. Shweta.
Sir.
Siddharth.
Present sir.
Sneha. Sneha. Surya. Saurav. Saurav. Bilal. Vijit.
Yes sir. Yes sir.
Suman.
Present sir. Present sir.
Sunit.
Present sir.
Sushma. Sushma.
Present sir.
Sushmit.
Present sir.
Present sir.
Sushmita.
Present sir.
Harshita. Harshita.
Present sir.
Hima.
Present sir.
Hima. Hima. Rida.
Present sir.
Altamash. Altamash.
Present.
Altaman. Amrin.
Present sir.
Bashiruddin. Bashiruddin. Sania.
Present sir.
Rizwan.
Present sir.
Ashwin. Ashwin. Rasil. Rasil. It's Rifa. Present or absent? Rifa. Rifa. So it's Ashwin and Rasil absent. Ashwin and Rasil. Okay. So we discussed many examples for the regular expressions, right? Okay. So yes. Is that okay? So that I'm going to stop here. Okay. So I'll stop here. I'll continue with this Kleene's theorem in the next class. So I'll be continuing with Kleene's theorem in the next class. Okay, so you can leave now.